In vitro comparison of porcine infused to metal crown retention after endodontic access and subsequent restoration. Composite amalgam, amalgam with composite veneer, and fiber post with composite. A study by Brzezinski et al., a group from University of Minnesota, published in 2020 in JOE. So vital teeth restored with full coverage can require subsequent endodontic therapy in 11% of the time, according to Goodacre 2003. Furthermore, it is common that the full coverage restoration be adequate and not require replacement. However, different material can serve in restoring the access cavity, and thus the aim of the study was to evaluate the effect of different access opening restorative materials on crown retention. For the materials and methods, the experiment was conducted in two phases on 38 extracted caries-free molars. Crowns were mounted in resin and prepared for BFM crowns, and the crowns were fabricated and cemented with zinc phosphate in this study, and the force to displace it was measured with a tensile testing machine before and after endodontic access preparations. The endodontic access area, crown preparation, axial wall, and preparation surfaces, surface area were measured for comparison, and the crowns were then re-cemented after the first phase, and access opening were restored with materials, either amalgam or composite, before displacement was re-measured. And afterward, different materials were also used again with amalgam, with composite veneer, or fiber post with composite. And again, displacement force were re-measured, and pair t-test was used to compare the means of displacement between groups. For the results, statistical analysis showed retention after unfilled access was significantly lower than intact crowns. Amalgam with composite veneer and fiber post with composite increased the retention beyond the original value, and there was no statistical difference among the different restorative protocols. Also, qualitative results indicate that the restorative material remains in the crown after displacement, regardless of the material used to restore the access. And for conclusion, the results from this study suggest that an endodontic access cavity decreases retention of a BFM crown. However, subsequent restoration with amalgam, composite, amalgam and composite, or post and composite may increase the original retention of the crown.